In the previous session, we discussed electrostatics. In that electrostatics, already we discussed electric field and Gauss law and applications of Gauss law. First of all, what is electric field definition? Then, after that, electric field in different cases, point charge, surface charge and volume charge, and also electric field due to a point charge, electric field due to a line of charge, electric field due to a charged sphere. And after that, we discussed about Gauss law and applications of Gauss law also. In that applications of Gauss law, we discussed electric field due to a point charge, electric field due to a closed solid sphere, and electric field due to a hollow sphere. And after that, we discussed about Maxwell's equations. Maxwell's equation, that is Gauss law for electrostatics, Gauss law for magnetostatics, Ampere's law and Faraday's law. Up to now we discussed, that is about electrostatics. Today we are going to discuss about new topic, that is magnetostatics. Magnetostatics. In this magnetostatics, we have what is magnetic flux and Gauss law in magnetostatics. After that, Ampere's law, Faraday's law and Biot-Savart's law. These are the topics, and finally we will discuss about the Maxwell's equation in integral form. These are the topics in this magnetostatics. And first, what is what are the syllabus? Observe here, magnetostatics. First of all, what is magnetic flux and Gauss law in magnetostatics? Then Biot-Savart's law we will discuss today. Now observe here, before going to discuss about Gauss law, first of all, basic fundamentals in magnetostatics. Now, up to now we focused our attention on source charges at rest. In the electrostatics, what and all we discussed, in that case all these charges are at rest. But here magnetostatics refers to the study of forces and currents when these charges start moving. This is difference. In the case of electrostatics, all the charges are at rest. But here in this magnetostatics, we are going to study when the charges are start to moving. Two current carrying wires parallel to each other will either attract or repel each other depending on the current directions in this wire. Now here we are taking two current carrying wires. Here this is wire 1 and this is wire 2. Observe here in this diagram, current is in opposite directions. In the wire 1, it is going in this direction, and wire 2, it is going in this direction. The wire 1 in this direction. In that cases, current in opposite, then repel with each other. Here repel with each other. See, any cases will happen here, either attract or repel. Two current carrying wires parallel to each other will either attract or repel each other depending on the directions of the current flowing in that wires. And observe here in this is again here 1 and here 2, current is flowing in the same directions, then attraction. Current is flowing in this direction and in this direction, then attraction takes place here. And the force of attraction or repulsion between such current carrying wires is not electrostatic in nature. Why? Because in the case of electrostatics, all source charges are at rest, but here they are start to move. That's why these discussions will come under magnetostatics. Such a force is magnetic in nature. Now, whereas a stationary charge produces an electric field E in its region, moving charges produces in addition, that is called magnetic fields. Already you knew in the electrostatics, when positive charge is here, our electric lines of force are radially outwards, and if it is negative charges, all electric lines of force are radially inwards, like this. Here radially outwards, here outwards in this direction, and here radially inwards. observe here, such a force is magnetic in nature. Now we are considering two parallel, two current carrying conducting wires, current carrying wires. Here both in the both wires current is flowing opposite direction, then repel with each other. Here it is going in the same direction, then attract with each other. And in the case of electric, here electrostatics, that field we are representing E bar, that is electric field. But here in this case, in the case of magnetic field, we are representing either B or H. B or H. In order to understand this magnetic force, let us try to study about the effect of such wires and magnetic compass needle. That means if two wires are there, we are bringing that compass needle near to that wires and we are bringing away from that two wires. Then what will happen? Observe here. When a compass is brought close to a current carrying wire, the compass needle gets deflected. When, if it is near to that one. For example, here it is the compass needle, here north pole and south pole. Here you are, whenever here it is, object is there, current carrying wire, this one, current is flowing I. Whenever it is near to this one, then this compass will deflect, maybe like this or like this, it will deflect. The magnetic field direction curves around such a wire as shown in the diagram below. Observe here, when this compass is close to here, then magnetic lines of force, that magnetic lines of force here, observe here, this is the current carrying wire, magnetic lines of force curl around this wire. Observe here, this is the direction, magnetic lines of force, that is shown in the figure. And when you come to the direction of the force, here there are three axes, x, y and z axis. See here, current along z axis and force along x axis and magnetic field along y axis. All are mutually perpendicular to each other. Current is flowing in this direction, current is flowing in this direction. And here observe here, this force is always perpendicular to both magnetic field as well as electric field, magnetic field as well as electric field. And that is called as Lorentz force, that is called as Lorentz force, that is F equal to Q E plus V velocity into B. This is given by Lorentz force, that is representing capital F bar. Here Q is the charge, and E is the electric field, and V bar cross B bar is the velocity into magnetic field. This is given by Lorentz force. And this force always perpendicular to both applied magnetic field as well as electric field. Magnetic field as well as electric field. And observe here, now that is, this is the basics in this case of magnetic field. And observe now what will happen when magnetic lines of force are passing through circular plane. Here first we are discussing magnetic flux and Gauss law in magnetism. Now observe here what will happen, magnetic lines of force are passing particular region. Already we studied in the electrostatics, when this plane is there, all electric charges distributed uniformly throughout this plane according to Gauss law in electrostatics. What is the flux? That is representing by pi, always equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in this plane. For example, here charge Q, it is there, charge Q. Then according to Gauss law in electrostatics, we already knew total flux through this surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed in this surface, Now coming to this magnetostatics, we have used magnetic field lines to visualize the magnetic fields and indicate their strength. We are now going to count the number of magnetic field lines passing through particular surface and use this count to determine the magnetic field. Observe here how many number of, here I am taking this plane, how many number of magnetic lines of force are passing through this surface, passing through this surface. Observe here now, this is the, for example, here this is the vector A, like this vector A, and how many number of magnetic lines of force are passing when you are compare, when you are taking this, this is the vector, this is normal to the plane, magnetic lines of force are passing this one and this is normal to the plane, and this is the second case, and third case observe here, here third case, just it will, it will tilt from this axis with an angle theta, with an angle theta. Now then, what is the magnetic lines of force? Observe here, magnetic flux passing through a surface is the number of magnetic lines passing in the, in the, in this surface, how many number of magnetic lines are passing in this surface, that is given by magnetic flux, and that is representing here pi suffix m equal to B applied magnetic field and A is the area, applied magnetic field and A is the area. This is general magnetic flux in the case of magnetostatics, but now observe in this another case, this plane is tilted lightly theta, then now what is the magnetic lines of force? Again here, here A vector, A here vector A in this direction. Now what is the flux in this case? Observe here, here magnetic lines of force passing and this is the tilted area here, theta region, and here area A, we are considering small area, that is in this direction and theta, and magnetic lines of force B, representing B. Now already you knew pi suffix m equal to B A, but here this A component is here A cos theta, B dot A, B A cos theta. Observe here, the amount of surface perpendicular to the magnetic field is here A cos theta, because A is perpendicular to the surface, this A is the perpendicular to this surface, the amount of A parallel to the magnetic field is A cos theta, the amount of A is the parallel to that one, and here whenever you are considering, that is divided into, one is A cos theta and one is A sin theta, and parallel to magnetic field, that is A cos theta, and perpendicular, this is A sin theta. This A vector is, vector A is resolved into two components, one is A cos theta parallel to magnetic field, A sin theta perpendicular to that plane. Now we are considering this here, instead of A cos theta parallel to magnetic field, and A becomes here A cos theta, then flux is phi suffix m equal to phi suffix m, flux is B dot A, that is given by B A cos theta, B A cos theta. This is the magnetic flux when that this plane, this surface is just tilted. Now another case, what is the magnetic flux if the region is closed surface region? Observe here, the region is closed surface region. See here, now magnetic lines of force are passing, but what now we are considering, this is the closed surface region, that vector. Again here, this A parallel to this magnetic lines of force dA cos theta and perpendicular otherwise dA sin theta. Observe here now, we count the lines going out as positive and lines going in as negative. If magnetic lines of force, how many it is going outside, that is positive, how many lines inside, that is negative, and already you knew pi m is representing B dot dA. Here this is the surface integral, surface integral, we are here, we are taking that closed surface, and here we have to take both double integral, double surface integral. Observe here, because we are considering this closed surface, closed surface B dot dA, magnetic flux is representing like this. Now here observe here one thing, one very important thing here, here how many magnetic lines of force are entering in this surface, here how many magnetic lines of force are entering, same number of magnetic lines of force are leaving, there are, that means already you knew magnetic flux is defined as how many number of magnetic lines of force passing through particular surface. Here how many number of magnetic lines of force entering and leaving are equal. In that case this becomes zero. Now from this we are concluding there are no magnetic monopoles in nature. If there were more flux lines going out of that into this volume, there would be a magnetic monopole inside. This law may be requires modification if the existence of magnetic monopoles is confirmed. Now in this case, magnetic lines of force, how many magnetic lines of force are passing in this region? Same magnetic lines of force are, how many lines entering, how many lines leaving, same. That's why in this case this B dot BDA cos theta, then this becomes zero. Already you knew magnetic flux is representing B dot A. Now that theta becomes here, theta becomes 90 degree, then BA cos theta, then cos 90 becomes 0. This is about the magnetic flux, Gauss law in magnetic flux. We discuss first of all one plane surface, and when that plane surface is tilted at some angle, then what is the magnetic flux? And the surface is completely closed like this, then what is the magnetic flux? From this we are concluding that one, magnetic monopoles are not existing. That means like here positive charge, in the case of electrostatics, electric lines of force are radially outwards. This is in the case of positive charge. If it is negative charge, electric lines of force are radially inwards. Like this, magnetic lines of force always, for example, this is the north pole, this is the south pole, always these lines of force are passing like this. Individually it is not possible, only at north pole or only at south pole. Monopole does not exist. That is the conclusion from this Gauss law in magnetism. Monopoles does not exist. Always magnetic lines of force passing from one pole to another pole. Like here this field is representing, for example, this field is representing E bar. Whenever you are representing this magnetic lines of force, always from one pole to another pole, there is no individual pole exist. That monopole does not exist in this case of magnetic field. This is the conclusion from Gauss law. Now observe here, what is Lorentz force? If you are considering one charged particle, what is the Lorentz force? The force on a charged particle in the presence of both electric and magnetic field is called the Lorentz force. Lorentz force is representing by equation F equal to Q E bar electric field V bar into B bar, and where Q is the charge of that particle and E is the electric field, V is the velocity, B is the magnetic field. V is the velocity of that particle, and it can be understood that the direction of Lorentz force is along the direction of V bar, V into V cross B bar, and hence perpendicular to the directions of both electric field and magnetic field. In the absence of electric field, if electric field is not there, charged particle is there here, we are applying both electric field and magnetic field. But if it is only in the presence of charged particle here, only magnetic field. In this case, force is given, force is purely magnetic in nature, and hence it is representing F suffix magnetic field, that Q into V bar cross B bar. This is the force when only we are applying in the, this is the force equation in the presence of only magnetic field. Here both the fields, electric field as well as magnetic field. This indicates that this equation gives that electric field accelerates the charged particle, whereas magnetic field puts the particle in circular orbit. Observe here. In the case of electric field, Q into E bar. But in the case of magnetic field, Q into V bar cross B bar. Cross product it is there here. V bar cross B bar. Here it is only accelerating charged particles here. But whereas magnetic field puts the, here in this case always this is in circular orbit. Always in circular orbit. Charged particle in circular orbit. If it is only electric field, this charged particle accelerates, electric field accelerates the charged particle, but whereas in the case of magnetic field puts that particle in circular orbit. Circular orbit. For example, this is the here electric line like this. Circular orbit. Charged particle. This is about Lorentz force. The force on a charged particle in the presence of both magnetic field as well as electric field, then it is called as a Lorentz force. And next one, observe here. Magnetic force on a current carrying wire. What is the magnetic force? We previously it was on a particle, now it is current carrying wire. What is the magnetic force? Now, the current in the wire is defined as the charge flowing for unit time. Charge flowing for unit time. Observe here. Therefore, ampere of current is 1 coulomb of charge flowing through the wire per second. Here, observe here. This is the wire. And here, line of charge traveling. Here, we are considering line of charge, that is a linear density. Line of charge lambda traveling on a wire at a speed v gives rise to here line of charge lambda. Lambda is the line of charge, v is the speed, then current I is representing lambda into v, because a segment of length here, in this segment only we are considering how much charge flowing for unit time. That is flowing, charge flowing for unit time, that is given by current. Here in this particular region we are considering, then segment of length V delta T carrying a charge delta V into lambda V into delta T is passing a point P in a time interval of delta T, Now what is the magnetic force on a segment of current carrying wire? Here what is the magnetic force? Already you knew, whenever charged particle is there, both magnetic force as well as electric force are there. Now here in this case, what is the magnetic force on a segment of wire carrying wire? Already you knew equation V cross B into DQ, and here DQ charge, here we are considering lambda into DL, that is the current is flowing through along the wire, and lambda is the charge density, linear charge density. Lambda into DL is the length here. That's why we are writing instead of DQ, lambda into DL, And already you knew V lambda is given by, I. Then this equation becomes here, capital I into B, DL. F, in the case of magnetic field, is given by I cross B DL. Otherwise, I DL B sin theta. F maximum. This is the vector product. I B DL sin theta. This is the magnetic force equation. Current carrying wire. That means current is flowing in this wire. What is the equation? Now observe here another one. And line has both I and DL point in the same direction. If both current and this length are in the same direction, then we can write that equation IDL cross B bar. Before it is F maximum equal to integral I cross B bar into DL. But here, observe here, both current and length in the same direction. Then we can write this equation becomes here, I is outside, DL into B bar. Here this also we will write it, if it is in integral form, I DL cross B. This is the force in particular wire, what is the magnetic force. Now second case, magnetic field due to a current carrying wire. Magnetic field due to a current carrying wire. This is given by Biot-Savart's law. And according to this law, magnetic field B of R, or is B, is directly proportional to the current passing through that wire, and directly proportional to the length DL sin theta, and inversely proportional to distance. Here observe here, this is the current carrying wire. We are considering small element area DL, which is at a distance r, from this point r, which is at a distance r. Now what is the magnetic field, what is the force here, and magnetic field, that is given by mu naught 4 pi I cross R by R square into DL. Mu naught I by I is constant, take outside of the integral. Mu naught I by 4 pi DL cross R by R square. This expression gives the magnetic field produced by a steady current I, and the constant of proportionality in the above expression is here, this one is mu naught, and mu naught is the permeability of free space. Now BR of B directly proportional to I, directly proportional to DL sin theta, and inversely proportional to 1 by R square. Whenever you are writing this one, B is here I DL sin theta by R square, and this proportionality constant here, it is given by B equal to mu naught by 4 pi, then this all this equation I DL sin theta by R square. Mu naught is the permeability of free space. Observe here, you have to observe one important point here, this always current is steady current here. Current flowing through this region is steady current, no change in the current. In this case, this is given by Biot-Savart's law, that is magnetic field directly proportional to the current passing through this wire and inversely proportional to the how much distance from this point to here, inversely proportional, and also directly proportional to DL sin theta. Here we are considering, and this is the sin theta, and this is the theta value. Then you have to take that what and all parallel to that magnetic field, that is sin theta component. When you are resolve that component to two, one is cos theta, another one is sin theta, and here in this case sin theta we are considering, that is sin theta component is parallel to the applied magnetic field. Now here this is directly proportional and directly proportional, inversely proportional. When you combine all this, then you are writing B is directly proportional to IDL sin theta by R square. Then this proportionality constant mu naught by 4 pi. And this proportionality constant mu naught is the permeability of free space. This is about Biot-Savart's law. Integral form this one. Mu naught I by 4 pi, proportionality constant. Here mu naught by 4 pi, I DL cross R by R square. Otherwise DL sin theta by R square. This is about Biot-Savart's law, and observe here mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 Newton per ampere square or Henry meter, and the integration is along the current path in the direction of the flow, and dl is an elemental length along the wire, and r is the vector from the source to the point r. In that equation, integration is along that path. Here complete this path, how much it is there, integration, and here we are considering small element dl, and r is the vector here, this one, from here to this point. Now, another case, calculate the magnetic field at a distance x from a straight wire carrying a current I along the y direction. Observe here, now this is the another case, we are going to calculate the magnetic field. Here magnetic field is flowing along this direction, here sorry, current is flowing along in this direction, and here we are considering small element dy here, this one. This is at a distance y from center, and at a distance r, at a distance r, this point here, point, and from here to here x, here to here x, and we are calculating what is the magnetic field in the y direction, magnetic field in the y direction. Observe here, from this point we are considering, this is the small element, and we are considering a point here, what is the magnetic field at this point, we are going to calculate. Already you knew by using Biot-Savart's law, here observe here, magnetic field at a point P due to the wire carrying current can be computed using the Biot-Savart's law, where integrating the infinitesimal element of the wire dy, this one, over the entire length from here to here of the wire, and by using this Biot-Savart's law, already you knew the equation mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin I cross r bar by r square, mu naught I by 4 pi, and integration dl into y, and here dl we are considering dy means small, there we are considering small length dl, here we are going to calculate magnetic field in the y direction, in this direction we are considering the small element as dy. Now integrate this equation from here to here, then we will get it the magnetic field into magnetic field. Observe here, this equation becomes now here. Current is constant, and hence take out of the integral, current value is take out of the integral, and r is here, already you know x square plus y square whole to the power of 1 by 2, r is here x square plus y square. Observe here in this diagram, r value is x square plus y square, and take this current outside, and here dy, this one dy here, dy sin theta, and substitute in this equation for solving this integral, complete this in order to calculate the magnetic field throughout the length, we are substituting here y equal to x tan theta, then to solve that above integral equation, and we get it y equal to x tan theta, and integral this one dy equal to dx into secant square theta into d theta. Now substitute this value, here dy is there, substitute that value in this equation, then you will get it, the value mu naught I by 4 pi, dx secant square theta into d theta, d theta, and here actually this is integral from 0 to L length, that one, then when you are substituting here y equal to x tan theta, then what will happen, this integration also will change from theta 0 to 2 pi, here we are considering only in this direction, only this plane, then what will happen here, 0 to pi by 2, here this 2 is not there, and here also 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, and observe here, these are the constant outside, mu naught I by 4 pi, and here y secant square theta into d theta, here x, this one, observe here, here this is the x secant square theta into d theta, then what will happen? X secant square theta into d theta by here already you knew r square it is there, this r square becomes already r square becomes x square plus y square, and x square instead of y square we are writing x square tan square theta, x square tan square theta, and this x square take common 1 plus tan square theta, 1 plus tan square theta, then what will happen? This secant square theta and this secant square theta get cancelled, secant square theta and secant square theta get cancelled, then b equal to mu naught I by 4 pi, 4 pi, here integral 0 to pi by 2, integral 0 to pi by 2, there secant square theta get cancelled, and this x here, x square down, 1 x, 1 by x, this is also take outside, take outside, then here, here 1 theta is there, that is cos theta into d theta, here cos theta into d theta, when you are integrating this cos theta, then when you are integrating this one, what will happen? Cos theta becomes sin theta, sin theta substitute here 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, then you will get it finally this one here, finally you will get it this one mu naught I by b equal to we will get it final equation b equal to mu naught I by 4 pi x. This will get it the equation. Here we are integrating along y direction, we will get it y not x here. From here also this is y. Here also y square, y square. Mu naught I by 4 pi y, mu naught I by 4 pi y. Means here magnetic field depends on the y here along x, along this direction. How much from center point to here, how much, what is the distance? From here to here it is x, it is here to here it is y, and this is the r. How much distance? That is depending on both applying current as well as the length, as well as the length. This is about magnetic field due to a straight wire, straight wire. Now observe here another case. This is another case to calculate magnetic field. Here we are considering circular shape, and we are considering at this small area, and we are going to calculate magnetic field due to this small, due to this small element. Calculate the magnetic field at a point which is at a distance z, at a distance z. From center to here it is z. From the center of the circular loop of radius r, this is the radius capital R carrying a current I, capital I. It is going in this direction, current is capital I. Now what is the magnetic field? Already you knew this. The horizontal component of the magnetic field due to any element of the loop is cancelled. Here we are considering both vertical and horizontal in this space. The horizontal component, what will happen? How much this side, same magnitude this side, then cancel with each other. Only vertical component only we are taking. This vertical component, this theta from this side, finally it will come in this direction. Hence, only the vertical component, that is cos theta, contributes the magnetic field at a point B, at a point P. That's why we are considering mu naught I by 4 pi dl cos theta by r square. And here r equal to, already you knew r equal to, here r equal to capital R square plus z square, and cos theta equal to r by r, this r by this r, cos theta equal to cap r by r. Now substitute that mu naught I by 4 pi, and this cos theta also outside, cos theta also outside, r square also outside, one integral dl, integral dl, and integration from here 0 to 2 pi 0 to 2 pi r, complete radius 0 to 2 pi r. Then what will happen? This becomes L here and 0 to 2 pi r. Then this is the 2 pi r. This integral value is 2 pi r. That value substituted here, cos theta by r square 2 pi r, here 2 pi r, and cos theta already you knew, r by r, here cos theta 1, cos theta equal to r by r, and here upper side 2 pi into r, this is 2 pi r square, and 4 pi r cube, this r cube becomes here, r cube becomes, this is by 3 by 2. This is the final value equation, mu naught I by here 2 pi get cancelled, then 2 here, then 2 here, pi pi get cancelled, 2 into 2 here, mu naught I by 2 r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. This is the magnetic field due to a circular carrying current wire I. Current is going to the circular path, capital I. What is the value? B equal to mu naught I by r square, this radius, and r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. Here B is depends on both. See here current, how much current is passing through this closed path, and r radius from here to here, and also it also inversely proportional to this distance, how much distance from this center, from the center. This is the equation, and this equation, this already you have magnetic field due to at a point. This same theoretical value, what and all we are calculating, this you have in the engineering physics lab also. Here B equal to mu naught I by 2 r square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2. This is the magnetic field equation when current is passing through this closed path. Current I is passing through this closed path. And in this session we discussed about the magnetic flux and magnetic introduction to magnetic field, and as well as magnetic flux and gas law in magnetism, gas law in magnetostatistics, and a magnetic field in different cases, that is thin wire, and also in the case of straight wire passing through that one and in a particular point. And another one we discussed in the last session, that is magnetic field due to a closed circular path. In this session, you have any doubts, please contact by using this mail id tamna.nitk@gmail.com and my mobile number. Okay, thank you.